Lilith's Silver Moon wondered whether she should do chromosome testing on embryos, also known as PGS or PGT, when using egg donation. Let's explore this question. Human beings make lots of abnormal, non-viable embryos. The most common type are embryos that do not have the correct number of chromosomes. The older a woman gets, the higher the percentage of embryos that will have chromosome abnormalities. There are three possible outcomes if embryos with chromosome abnormalities are placed into your uterus. Most of the time, the embryos don't implant and you simply don't get pregnant. Of those that do implant, most will miscarry. Chromosome abnormality is the most common cause of miscarriage. A very small number of embryos will result in live-born babies. But these babies will have birth defects such as Edwards syndrome, which will cause the death of 90% of babies before they are 1 year old. So, should testing for abnormal embryos be performed on all IVF cycles, including egg donor cycles? Maybe not. Let's look at the three problems I listed before. Will it actually help you to get pregnant? As an IVF expert, I am looking to see whether I get more women pregnant using PGD compared to not using PGT. Younger women make fewer abnormal embryos than older women. Egg donors are usually young, so egg donors usually have a lower percentage of abnormal embryos. That means that any embryo that my embryologist chooses for transfer is less likely to be abnormal if it comes from an egg donor. So testing all embryos is less useful in egg donors than it is for older women. In fact, several studies have failed to find a difference in the chance for pregnancy when comparing IVF cycles in younger women and egg donors with tested embryos compared to the same younger women who had transfer of untested embryos. In other words, using tested embryos in younger women did not improve the chance for success. Currently, embryo testing is very costly, so it may not make sense for younger women and egg donors. That does not mean that it is impossible for a few individuals within those groups to benefit from testing, but there won't be very many that will benefit. Most of the time, couples using an egg donor will have the same chance for success without PGT. When does it make sense to use PGT in egg donor cycles? If a couple is interested in gender selection, then embryo testing is needed, or if the male partner has a known chromosome problem, like a translocation, then PGT may be warranted. Our Infertility TV bottom line: doing PGT on embryos from donor eggs is most likely not going to be of any benefit, so save your money. I now have three very important things for you to do. Number one, like this video. Number two, subscribe to this channel. And number three, watch this playlist with more videos about egg donation.